If you don't know, Anansi the spider has all stories in the world named after him. And the reason is because of the story I'm about to tell. This story actually takes place in a Caribbean isle. So tonight I'm going to share with you this story with a little dialect. You see, the story begins like this. Anansi the spider decided him wanted to go party. And there was no place to party like the Caribbean. So he goes to his favorite island, and he gets off the boat, and he jumps down, and he goes, "Hey, man, where the party at?" And all the men and the women in the village went, "Shh. What you mean, shh? Where the party at?" And he breathes in. "I don't smell no jerk chicken. I don't hear no calypso music, man. What's the problem?" "Shh, Anansi, don't talk, man. It's the snake." "What snake, man?" "The big snake. This snake is so big, man, that whenever we have a party and we have on our bright clothes and we play our music and we have our food, him comes up and hum, him eats us. In fact, him eat all the cows, man. That's why no cows on the island." Anansi goes, "Man, why don't you just kill the snake?" "No, man. Y'all see the great God in the sky? Him say we can do whatever we need to this snake, but we can't kill him. You can't kill him. You can do anything." He says, "And whoever gets away and figures out how to handle him, he'd give him a great gift." Well, Anansi think, "Man, this is a great thing." So he goes to the sky god and says, "Sky god, if I can get rid of this snake, can we have all stories named after me?" And the sky god says, "Yes." So Anansi called the villagers. He says, "This is what I need. I need me some wine. I need me some mangoes. I need me some sweet eggs. And I need you to cut me some rope and lay it by that long tree over there." And they do everything Anansi wants. And while they're going, Anansi goes over to the hole where the snake be hiding where him sleep. And he stands on one side and he goes, "I hear that brother snake is the largest and the biggest snake in all the world." And then him sneak over to the other side. Says, "Nah, man, I don't think he's that big at all. He's just an average size snake." "No, man, I'm telling you, this snake is huge. He bigger than that log over there, man. Him huge. I'm telling you, man, the snake is average. We could probably take him and kill him ourselves, man. He's not that big." "You better leave here, man. I'm telling you, this snake is wonderful. He is huge." And after he gets done, he reaches over and he grabs the sweet eggs and he rolls it in front of the hole. And the snake goes, "Hum!" And he eats it. And then he gets him two big long loaves of bread that look like arms and he throws it in front. And the snake know not see well, but he hear the vibrations and hum. And then he goes and throws mangoes, hum, hum. And then him grab a big skin of wine and throw in front, hum. By that time, the snake is not only full, but he's feeling well too, man. So he starts talking to the snake. He says, "Snake, can you come here for a minute, man?" And the snake comes out of the hole. He says, "Man," he says, "I hear that you are the longest snake in all the world." And the snake says, "Yes, I think I'm very long." It says, "But these guys don't believe you, man. I say that you prove it, man. I say you're longer than that log over there, man." And the snake looked out and said, "Yes, yes, I think I'm longer as well. Let's go see. Line yourself up over there." And the snake goes and he wiggles himself out. And he wiggles himself out. And he's longer and he's longer and he's longer. And he gets over to that log and he's about that much too short. Anansi said, "Man, I think that you can make it, man, but you're just a little short. Why don't you stretch, man?" And so the snake stretches some. He says, "Man, but that's too hard. Why don't you let me tie you at the bottom so you can hold on a little bit?" And the snake says, "Tie me, man." So he ties the snake on the pole. And the snake goes a little longer, and he's only about just a couple inches too short. And Anansi turns to him and says, "It's your bark, man. Let me tie your middle." And the snake says, "Go, man, tie me middle." And he ties him up in the middle, and he's just a little bit too short. He says, "Man, stretch with all your might, and I'll tie your head, man." And the snake stretches and stretches and stretches, and he gets just a little bit beyond that thing, and Anansi ties his head. He says, "Man, can you move?" And the snake says, "No, man, me can't move." And Anansi turns to the crowd and says, "Hey, man, where the party at? The snake, we got the snake." And you know what them do? They put on their nice clothes. They pull out their calypso music, and they start cooking hogs and chickens and just having a party. And Anansi take that snake, and he take him, and he throw him into the water. And there in the water, he start to float away, float away, float away. And they say that that snake ended up in a place called South America. And do you know the name of that snake today? That snake, they call him the python. And you know what? From that day to this, every story is named after Anansi. And that is my story.